Hi, welcome to Start Studies course. Sushmita here. I am starting again with part 13 of electronics, class 11. As we already discussed series and parallel combination of resistors in a closed circuit, today I am going to talk about series versus parallel combination and how they are different, and it will, I think that this video will clear your concept 100%. I guarantee that. So stay tuned, do not forward this video till the end, watch till the end. If you need also, you can take a screenshot of the video, as well as you can write it down in your notebook. And as I have told, this video is only for subscribers. So without any delay, please subscribe my channel so that you will be notified as soon as I upload a new video. So let's get started. Now, I have put this comparison in a proper way. Differentiation, but it is, you can see I have mentioned it in a very very easy language so that you can also understand what's going on. Now you can see in series I have already drawn the diagram here, which is very much you can see it pretty, you can relate to it, right? Now in parallel combination of resistor, you can see the diagram, you have seen it before also. First of all, I would like to give the example for each of the combination. In series combination, if the decorative lights are combined end to end, you can notice that, right? And that is actually called series combination. Now in domestic wiring, there is parallel combination of appliances. So how it helps and why we exactly do that, that's we are going to discuss. Now, as we know, the in series combinations, the resistors are connected lengthwise or end to end, whereas in parallel, they are combined in column wise like this, like in a column, right? Then after that, I already insisted on the formula. In series combination, R dash would be R1 plus R2, depending upon the number of resistors we are having, we will write that. But in parallel combination, that formula is the reciprocal. And I also proved that the net resistance in case of parallel is basically smaller than the individual resistances. Whereas in series combination, the net resistance is usually higher. So when we need higher R, we will combine it with series combination. And the place where we need less resistance, then we will combine the appliances or resistors in parallel combination. Now next, after that, we can see, I have written another point. One switch will work for appliances combined in series. What do you mean by that? There will be one switch which you can turn off or make it connected so that all the resistors are in series and end to end like this. If you put one switch turn on here, then all started conducting. Now when you delete it, then the switch is off, you make it turn off, then all the appliances in a row are shut down. So that's why I have written in series combination, one switch will be enough for appliances combined in series combination. But that won't be happening in parallel combination. You need to turn on or off. If you want to do it, you need to do it separately. So that's why where do we need to do it separately? In domestic appliances, isn't it? If I'll start the geyser, the AC, the motor, everyone, I'll start at once with a one switch, then it will load up the wire and burn it. Like that's why all the appliances in domestic wiring are combined in parallel combination. Okay, that's why we do need to have separate switches for each and every appliance or plug, so that whenever we plug in or switch on, then only the appliance of the respective appliance will work. not the other way, like in series combination. But in decorative lights, you just need to plug in one plug or one switch, you have to turn it on. So all the lights in a row will be will be glowing. But in this case, when the appliance is having less resistance, we need to act very carefully. That's why there are separate plugins or separate switches for each of the individual appliances, or we can say resistor. That's the importance of parallel combination. Next, in series combination, the power supply is actually divided into various parts. Why? Because the V is always varying, as we said. This kind of thing, when the voltage starts flowing, if this resistor is 1 ohm, here the voltage will be similarly less. But if it is 5 ohm, here voltage will be similarly high. So as the voltage will be varying, the power supply gets divided into various parts. But in parallel combination, always the power supply remains the same. And that's why it is useful in domestic wiring. You must understand this. In domestic wiring, the power supply in each of the individual switch, everywhere, as it is combined in parallel, the total V remains the same. Okay, we studied in the previous class also. You can follow that up if you want to. Otherwise, if you do understand that video, so it must not be difficult for you today. Now, at last but not the least, I have written overall resistance increased, so the current will be low, and that's what we exactly want. The current is very low because the overall net resistance is high. If the net resistance is high in series circuit, as we already said, because we are simply adding the resistances up in lengthwise, R dash is very high. And that's why I will be low. Okay? And that's why the decorative lights are simply glowing. They are not differentiated by their intensity. The voltage is also different in series circuit. So these all are the perspective I have put in this video, which I think will be very helpful for you people. Now here in parallel combination, the overall R is decreased. Why so? Because we already decided that the net resistance is a reciprocal, okay, of sum of all the individual reciprocal of individual resistances. So as the R is low and the length is not increasing, that's why the current which is being distributed along the appliances or the R's or resistors, it will be high. So these are the comparison or the comparative study of series and parallel combination in a closed circuit. So what can be next? Now let's go to analytical part of this. What will happen if we arrange the domestic appliances? Let's say like one AC, one fridge, one geyser, all in a series. What will happen? Can you think of it? If I connect one switch to AC as well as a geyser, as well as a fridge, and whatever you want, a bulb also, with one switch. What will happen, you think, when you turn on this switch, right? When you turn it on, what will happen? When the switch is on, then all will be started at once, which will be, the voltage will be so varied and the resistance will be so high, because we already discussed the resistance when it is connected in series, the overall R is increased. So as the R will be increased, what will happen? It will put load. The load is the differential form of resistance only. So R will be very, very high. Okay, and we know R depends on length of the wire, area of cross section of the wire, and the temperature constant is also there, temperature coefficient, right? So if these things are involved, can we afford to start all the things at once? No, we cannot. So this is the disadvantage of connecting all the domestic appliances to one switch. Another thing, when power is off, if we want, okay, AC should be off, fridge should be off, so it should not run on the inverter, geyser should be off. But what about this little bulb? It has been glowing. So it is also showing that, no, it can't glow because the power is off and the switch is off. And we don't want that. So that's why when we need the AC, fridge, geyser to shut down, we simply need three different switches other than the switch for a bulb. So that's why domestic appliance, the in domestic wiring, they take care that the wire are have specific length, specific area of cross section. That means its thickness is involved, and they can bear a temperature, good temperature coefficient. And they are made up of good alloy like manganese, nichromware, and like that. And also they take care that all the appliances or the heavy load appliances should be connected in parallel, which is a motive behind it. So this is why we should take care and precaution whenever we are a circuit is designed for domestic wiring. If it, all the appliances should not have one point of contact or a switch. Like if one is turned off, all the appliances along them will be turned off. We don't want that. Next, if they are not getting same voltage, then what will happen? They will not work properly. If not same voltage, if V is not same, what will happen for domestic appliances? AC is getting, okay, 220 exact. For India, it is 220 volt. Outside in like in US and other thing other countries it may be 110, I would say. So if the AC is drawing 220 volt, then again it will be divided, and after it reaches at the long bottom to the bulb may be getting 10 volt only. So that is not exactly what we need. So that is why we do not connect any appliances in series. We do need to connect it to a voltage which remains same, and it will draw the same voltage from the source itself. That's why parallel wiring is done in domestic household. So this is it for today. I hope you like my video. Do watch my videos, subscribe my videos, because it will be only for subscribers in some time. Take care. Have a good day.